Hi everyone, I'm not easily impressed when a new action camera hits the market, but when I first learned about the specs and the price of Xiaomi Mia, it immediately caught my attention. Great specs for an awesome price, so is this the new star among the action cameras? Let's find out.
So in this episode, I'm going to compare Xiaomi Mia action camera with Yi 4K action camera, GoPro Hero 5 Black and Firefly 8S action camera. But there's more, you can win a Xiaomi Mia action camera. More on that at the end of the video, but now let's start with an audio comparison. So this is Yi 4K action camera, and currently all cameras are placed outside their underwater case. I'm outdoor and there is a slight wind and some background noise. So before I want to show you some test footage with these cameras, let's take a look at the specs, which I want to go through one by one. So you can check and compare which specs are important for the camera you are looking into for the situations you need. So why did I choose those four cameras?
Yi 4K action camera has similar specs compared to Xiaomi Mia. It offers a little more features, but is also a little more expensive. Yi Lite action camera has a similar price tag to Xiaomi Mia, but I wanted to do a comparison in 4K resolution and Yi Lite only offers 20 frames per second. I'll do a separate comparison, you can find the link on the top right. Yi 4K Plus action camera offers even more features and records 4K resolution with 60 frames per second and has image stabilization up to 4K resolution and 30 frames per second. GoPro Hero 5 Black is the cheapest GoPro to offer a touchscreen, which the cheaper session models don't feature. GoPro has way more features, but for the price of a Hero 5, you can get almost 4 Xiaomi Mia cameras. Again, there's also the new GoPro Hero 6 Black with even more features, but it's another $100 extra. And I want to compare Firefly 8S, which is a little cheaper than Xiaomi Mia. It doesn't have a touchscreen, but in contrast comes with accessories included. Firefly 8S is available with a comparable 170 degrees field of view lens, and there is a 90 degrees field of view version with less distortion if you don't like the fisheye effect. So let's compare the specs. First of all, they all use a Sony sensor, but different models. Whereas Yi 4K, GoPro Hero 5 Black and Firefly 8S use a 12 megapixel sensor with 4:3 aspect ratio, Xiaomi Mia offers an 8 megapixel sensor. But that doesn't mean Mia's sensor is inferior. The aspect ratio is 16:9, so there is no disadvantage for video recording. Only with photos, you lose image space on top and bottom. By the way, the sensor used in Xiaomi Mia is the same sensor used in Sony's flagship action camera, the FDR X3000 and the new GitHub F1. The other cameras use a 12 megapixel sensor, but also different models. Yi 4K uses the newer IMX317 model, whereas Firefly 8S uses the older IMX117. That was also used in GoPro Hero 4 Black. I'm not quite sure which one the GoPro Hero 5 uses. According to my sources, it's either the one or the other. Another thing they have in common, they all use an Umbrella processor. GoPro Hero 5 Black and Yi 4K use the faster A9 processor, whereas Firefly 8S and Xiaomi Mia use the A12 processor. In terms of video recording, they all offer the same settings. Real 4K resolution up to 30 frames per second, 1080p up to 120 frames per second, and 720p up to 240 frames per second. All cameras offer electronic image stabilization, whereas Firefly 8S and Xiaomi Mia can do so up to 1080p with 60 frames per second, Yi 4K and GoPro Hero 5 Black can stabilize your footage up to 2.7K resolution with 60 frames per second. In photo mode, the highest resolution is linked to the sensor. Therefore, you can shoot 4:3 aspect ratio photos with 12 megapixels with Firefly 8S, Yi 4K and GoPro Hero 5 Black. Xiaomi Mia's highest resolution is 8 megapixel in 16:9 aspect ratio. Whereas all cameras can shoot JPEG photos, Firefly 8S is the only camera not capable of RAW photos. To frame your shot and replay them, all cameras offer a screen. Firefly 8S is the only camera that doesn't offer a touch screen. you have to navigate using the buttons. Whereas the other cameras all offer a touchscreen with different dimensions. GoPro Hero 5 Black has the smallest with 2-inch, Yi 4K offers 2.19-inch, and Xiaomi Mia offers the largest touchscreen with 2.44-inch. Well, a touchscreen is definitely a plus, as you can change the settings way faster. With the press of the button, you can access the video settings on Firefly 8S to change resolutions or frame rates. Press another button to access the device settings. The menu has a pretty clear structure, but many items you have to browse. I really like the menu of Xiaomi Mia Action Camera. Pretty simple and straightforward. Also, the camera settings are well structured and easy to choose from. In a second menu, you can find the general device settings of the camera. The menu of Yi 4K looks pretty much the same. I think it's a bit better than Xiaomi. It shows more information of the current settings and the structure is better organized with several submenus. The respond time is great and to me it's the best on-screen menu among those cameras. I really like the display of the current settings on GoPro Hero 5 Black. It's easier to check than on the other cameras. But I'm not a big fan of the menu structure. There are too many different menu locations and I'm often browsing the wrong one. The response is not as good as the other cameras, but to be fair, the touchscreen of Hero 5 is waterproof, whereas the others are not. A very important item of the action camera is the battery. Based on capacity, Firefly 8S offers the smallest with 1200 mAh. GoPro Hero 5 Black offers 1220 mAh. Yi 4K has a larger battery with 1400 mAh. And Xiaomi Mia offers the largest with 1450 mAh. The stated capacities also reflect my usage experience. Firefly 8S and GoPro Hero 5 Black record for a little over 1.5 hours, whereas Yi 4K records a little under 2 hours and Xiaomi Mia a little over 2 hours. Of course, it depends on how you use the camera, with Wi-Fi, Bluetooth or screen turned on or off. While we're on it, all cameras offer Bluetooth to connect to a remote controller and all cameras feature Wi-Fi to connect with respective app on your smartphone. In general, all apps show the live image, allow to remote control the camera or change the settings, and to download photos and videos to your smartphone for sharing and editing. GoPro has the most advanced app among them, which includes features as video trimming and a photo export from your video. You can also access all video informations. There's a second great app by GoPro called Quick that automatically edits your videos. You just need to select some clips and they are arranged by the app, which also includes music and title if wanted. The final clip is available in several formats for easy sharing on social media like Facebook or Instagram. You can give it a try, as GoPro Quick app is not limited to GoPro recordings. Yi Action app also offers some features, including its own photo and video sharing platform. It offers basic editing features like trimming videos or editing photos and applying filters. Xiaomi Mia's app is integrated into Xiaomi's Home app. It just has the basic features mentioned at the beginning. There are no editing features in the app itself. Since this is Xiaomi's first action cam, we might see further development. Xiaomi Mia 360 camera has a separate app with more features, and I heard a separate app for Mia action camera is planned. The Firefly app also doesn't offer many features besides live image, remote control, changing settings and downloading photos and videos. For editing, you need to use another app. Now let's take a look at the ports. All cameras record onto a microSD card. For 4K video recording, you need a class U3 card. GoPro Hero 5 Black and Firefly 8S offer a HDMI port. G4K and Xiaomi Mia don't. We can find all different USB ports on the cameras. Firefly 8S uses a mini USB port, whereas G4K and Xiaomi Mia use a micro USB port, and GoPro Hero 5 Black uses a USB-C port. That's important if you want to use an external microphone, which is technically not possible with micro USB. So you can only hook up a mic on Firefly 8S or GoPro Hero 5 Black via an adapter. As for G4K, you need to go for G4K Plus that offers a USB-C port similar to Hero 5. So how can you mount those cameras? Firefly 8S, Xiaomi Mia and G4K offer a 1/4-inch thread directly on the camera's body. I think that's pretty convenient, so you can mount them on any standard photo gear. If you place the camera inside the underwater case, all cameras feature the GoPro mounting system, so you can use any mounts that can hold a GoPro. I haven't received the Xiaomi Mia case for now, a test will follow, but pictures show the same mounting system. As you can see, GoPro Hero 5 Black is not placed in an underwater case as the cam is waterproof itself up to 10 meters. There is a case available if you want to dive deeper. That's a feature where GoPro stands out as none of the others offer that. GoPro Hero 5 Black offers voice control, which is pretty convenient for selfies. The latest firmware for G4K also enables voice control, which was launched with G4K Plus. I also saw a video of Firefly 8S testing voice control, which might be added soon. I currently don't have infos if that feature is also planned for Xiaomi Mia. Let's take a look at some other special features. G4K is currently the only cam that can do Facebook and YouTube live streaming. GoPro Hero 5 Black is the only cam that allows GPS recording, so you can display parameters such as speed, elevation, G-force and others in your video. So what's included when ordering one of those cameras? Xiaomi Mia, G4K and GoPro Hero 5 Black standard packaging just contain the camera, battery and a USB cable. Hero 5 also includes the frame so you can mount the camera. Underwater cases are optional accessories. Only Firefly 8S comes with an underwater case and a set of several mounts and accessories. Now let's start with a comparison of 4K footage. With this setting, none of the cams offer image stabilization, more on that later. I placed all camera recordings side by side so you can check saturation and exposure. Watch out when I pass the tunnel. It's a really tough call to point out the differences. Hero 5 and G4K have a bit wider dynamic range and are a little bit sharper. Xiaomi Mia seems to have the narrowest field of view and G4K the widest. Let me flip through the cameras for you to compare. You will hear the original audio recordings of each camera. But note that Xiaomi Mia was not in an underwater case as I didn't get it so far, as well as GoPro, as it is waterproof and not necessarily needed. For my second ride, I'm going to switch to 1080p so I can turn on image stabilization. As mentioned, stabilization is not available in 4K resolution, so for this comparison I set all cameras to 1080p, even though GoPro Hero 5 and G4K would offer stabilization also in 2.7K resolution. Again, let's switch through the different cameras and I replay the same section of the track so you can see the outcome in the same situation. All cameras were mounted on the same base. Be aware that the video now displayed in full screen is upscaled to 4K resolution. The next situation is a more usual use case where I was walking on an uneven ground. Again, as you can see from my shadow in the video, all cameras were mounted on the same base. In this scenario, it seems Yi 4K has the smoothest video output. Now all cameras sit on a tripod and I'm going to compare the center of each video side by side. I don't know why in this situation Yi 4K has a lower exposure. All settings were in auto mode. Let's zoom in at 300% so you can compare the details. Well, during the ride I had the impression Yi 4K and GoPro have a sharper image. Here the cam seems a little closer together. The shots seem not leveled because of the different field of view. Here's a slow pan so you can see the cams perform a little motion. As it is hard to compare the details after the YouTube compression, I'll upload some frame grabs and videos to my blog, so you can check them out. The link is in the video description below. Here's the same pan again, so you can check out the different field of views mentioned. So what's the conclusion? Well, basically you get what you pay for. And if you ask me which is the best action cam out of them, it's GoPro Hero 5 Black, simply because it offers the most features. But it also has the highest price tag, and the question is which camera has the best price performance ratio. In fact, if you compare the price of GoPro Hero 5 Black, it's the same as all the other three action cameras combined. If you plan to use it a lot, the money is well invested and it's nice to have all those features when needed. But if you use your action cam just now and then, does it justify spending so much money? I think it's important to figure out which features are needed in the situations you are going to use your action camera, and you might want to compromise for a lower price tag, because you also might want to spend some money on accessories like a gimbal. I hope I can help you with this comparison to figure out which action cam suits you the best. If your choice is Xiaomi Mia, I can help you even further, as you can win this brand new camera. Simply subscribe to my YouTube channel and comment below this video why you want to win this camera or what you plan to use it for, and I randomly pick a winning comment. You can find more infos in the video description below. So good luck to all of you, thanks for watching, and see you soon.